सदाशिव समारंभम शंकराचार्य अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंताम वंदे गुरु परंपरा श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानाम आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तं पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ब्रह्माण्ड जाति पूर्व वेदांश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंह देवात्मवृत्ति प्रकाशम मुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपच्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्री चिद्घन गणेशाय नमो। मह्यम सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेदृक्यत्व निर्मलं अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक् परं महः तदेवाहं नमत्वन्यदिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। सो वी आर लुकिंग एट दी फोर्थ चैप्टर in which the children have approached a guru following the footsteps of the king, their father, to get the Paramananda Rupa Atma, basically to attain moksha, which is Paramananda Rupa. And the guru has answered that the guru has said that the search for this Paramananda Rupa itself is a bhranti. This Ichha is bhranti janya, because you yourself are Paramananda Rupa. To this, the objection raised by the Shishya is, Tattva Drishti says, how is it that Ananda is the Swarupa of Atma? Because Atmanaha Ananda Rupatve. If it were so, Atmana Ananda Rupatve Sati, Vishaya Sambandhad Ananda Bhanam Na Uchitam Iti Akshepa. There won't be Ananda due to Vishaya Sambandha. But there is Ananda. There is a Pratiti of Ananda whenever there is Vishaya Bhoga. So what happens is that, so there was a question yesterday, as to what is Vishaya Sambandhad Ananda Bhanam. The setup in Vedanta is that Ananda Swarupa of Atma reflects in the Antakkarana. When there is a Vishaya Sambandha, that time it appears that the Sukha is due to Vishaya. Why? Because Ananda Swarupa of Atma, although it is ever present, what happens is that there is desire, there is craving for a particular object. And these are many, but we take one example. To explain, we take one example, any example of some Vishaya Kama. If there is a desire for Vishaya and Raga is Upalakshana there. Raga is Upalakshana, Dvesha is also included. But we give example of one Raga towards one Vishaya. When that Raga is there, that time making the person a wanting person. Now this person who is Ananda Swarupa somehow has desire in the Antakkarana, which manifests as desire for a Vishaya. Then wanting that particular Vishaya takes the person away from one's own Swarupa. One is always thinking how to attain this particular Vishaya, how to have Vishaya Bhoga. Thereby there is no rest in the Atma. The Antakarana is jumping here and there, the monkey mind. Therefore, one's own Swarupa Sukha is not known. This is manifest in Sushupti. The Ananda Swarupa of the Atma is manifest in Sushupti when there is no Vishaya at all. There is no Vishaya Raga at all. Similarly, in waking also, when there is Vishaya Raga, that time the person's outward pravritti takes one away from the swarupa ananda. Then what happens? The swarupa ananda not being felt and the vishaya not being attained, there is dukkha, pratiti of dukkha in the antakarana. Now the vishaya which one wants, if it comes in close proximity, then one has a particular kind of ananda manifest. Same ananda swarupa, because one knows that this vishaya is there, it is accessible. If I can afford it, I can have bhoga of that vishaya. Therefore, there is a gradation in ananda which is manifest. Initially, it is just priya more than pramoda, in that priya, I like this object, I would like to have bhoga of this vishaya. So it brings about some kind of an ananda, because that much, to that extent, the raga has reduced, because one has come in close proximity of that vishaya, has seen the vishaya, and then one somehow with resources one gains that vishaya. Then the ananda increases, because one knows that it is not away from me anymore, the vishaya. That is the moda gradation, moda level of sukha, which is manifest in the antakarana. Then when one partakes of this vishaya, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha, any of these vishayas, one experiences, one partakes, that time the raga for that vishaya is completely gone. At that moment, it may come back again, but in that fraction of a moment, the raga towards the vishaya is gone. Thereby, the dukkha which was there of separation from the vishaya goes away. And then one remains with one's own swarupa, which manifests, although due to vishaya, it seems due to vishaya, the ananda is not due to vishaya. It is one's own swarupa which manifests due to the lack of vishaya raga. At that moment, and that is called as pramoda. Now, these are just three levels mentioned. There can be gradations between also, but these are upalakshana. Talked about in the Shastra as Priya Moda Pramoda Vrittayaha. So these vrittis are, these are gradations of ananda, and gradations of ananda are experienceable ananda. Only in experienceable sukha it is possible. But the ananda which is the swarupa is not experienceable, because it is one's own swarupa of the subject. How will you objectify the subject? Subject cannot objectify the subject. So this is the process. And general experience is expressed by Tattva Drishti here when he says Vishaya Sambandhat Atma, Vishaya Sambandhat Atmani Anandaha. Naupapadyate Anubhuyate Eva. Anubhuyate Eva tu. There is an experience of Ananda in oneself when there is Sambandha with the Vishaya. How will you explain that if one's own swarupa is ananda swarupa? Tasma naiva ananda swarupa atma kintu vishaya sambandha deva atmani anando jayate. Ananda is born in atma, and it is not the swarupa of the atma. This is the objection. This is the question. Objection in sense, this is a dialectic. So it is a question raised by Tattva Drishti to know better. It is not challenging the guru, because he does not know any better. So the Guru explains, Ajnasya Vishaya Pravrutto Satyam Tadiya Antar Mukha Vrutto Atmanando Bhati. So what I just explained is, the Ajna, the ignorant, Ajnasya Vishaya Pravrutto, when there is Pravrutti towards Vishaya due to Raga, then Vishaya Pravrutto Satyam Tadiya Antar Mukha Vrutto Atmanando Bhati. Then when one attains that antarmukha vrittav, then antarmukha vritti happens, and then atma anandaha bhati. Visheshu nasti ananda iti samadhanam. The ananda is not really in the vishaya, इट इज युअर ओन स्वरूपानंद विच मैनिफेस्ट। हे शिष्य यस्य बुद्धि ही आत्मस्वरूपम न जानाति तस्य विषय इच्छा जायते। हु गेट्स दिस विषय इच्छा? वन हु डज नॉट हैव द ज्ञान दैट आई एम माइसेल्फ आनंद स्वरूप, देर इज नो सुखा इन विषय एट ऑल। फॉर दैट पर्सन आत्मस्वरूप यस्य बुद्धि आत्मस्वरूपम न जानाति तस्य विषय इच्छा जायते। Then once Vishayichcha is there, then there is Dukkha, Pratiti of Dukkha, because the want itself is in the form of Dukkha. That is why when you drop the want, Vairagya, one who has Vairagya is Sukhi. Shrotriyasya Chaka Mahatasya. So in the Ananda gradations also, in the Brahmananda Valli of Taittiriya Upanishad, there is so much of gradation of Ananda shown. Categorize Priya Moda Pramoda, but gradations across upadhis, across various upadhis, starting from the human upadhi, which is an ideal upadhi, which can never be attained. An emperor of the world, where the entire the world's wealth belongs to oneself, entire world's wealth belongs to oneself, and one is fit enough, trained by shastra, so there is no other kind of craving. So this person does not have dukkha due to the ashastriya raga dveshas, following dharma. So that kind of a person, an emperor of the world who is following shastra, trained in the shastras, and then he is also young enough to have bhoga, healthy enough. That kind of a person, Ananda is considered to be one unit of human Ananda. And then there is a comparison with other upadhis as one goes towards Hiranyagarbham. So, till one reaches that Brahmananda, not Brahmananda as Sarupananda, Brahma there is Hiranyagarbha. There are so many stages of becoming Pitru or Pitru Sharira or you know, in Swarga, various Shariras, Deva, Indra Sharira, Ityadi, Brihaspati, and so on, finally landing in Brahma, Hiranyagarbha. All these gradations are explained, and the Shastra says, why don't you get a better Upadhi to experience better Ananda than you can in this Loka, in this Sharira. One gets tempted and does karma for that purpose. But then one who is Shrotriya, one who knows the way it really is, Shrotriyasya cha, and does not have kama towards those objects which the Shastra discloses. Shastra reveals this kind of sukha is available, this kind of upadhi you can attain by this kind of a sadhana. One who does not have kama towards that, others are kamena hata. They are completely destroyed really. But under the influence of kama, basic meaning is under the influence of kama or kamahata. But this person is not kamahata. Na kamahata iti akamahata. So shrotriyasya cha akamahatasya cha. Shrotriyasya cha akamahatasya. That person will also get the same sukha which is available for the next upadhi, which is said to be 100 times of this upadhi sukha. And so on. So one who is a vairagi, he gets more sukha than of the particular upadhi that he is in, 100 times more. This is the gradation explained. And finally, the Swarupananda is beyond all gradations. It cannot be segmented or at all. It is abhinna. It cannot be segmented. That kind of a sukha, one is trying to hunt elsewhere. So, bhoga sadhana naam stri dhana putradi naam atra vishaya shabdena grahanam. What is this vishaya? Vishaya generally shabda sparsha rupa rasagandha. That is what we experience really. But then we don't think that I want shabda in this particular thing that I am looking for. I look at the vishaya where I seek a particular guna, but then I know it as a vishaya, as an object. Object which has that guna, although I experience the guna, I cognize the guna, I think that I want that object. I want to experience the object itself, not the guna. This is thinking. So, bhoga sadhananam stri dhana putradinam atra visheshabdena grahanam. It includes all that. Stri dhana putra ityadi. Visheshasya purushasya pumsaha. Visheshasya pumsaha buddhihi chanchala bhavati. Then buddhi becomes chanchala. It is moving outwards. So it becomes chanchala. Paranchikhani vetruna swayambhu says Katopnishad. Katopnishad mantra says that as and when a person is born, it is very naisargika to have one's indriyas focused outwards towards the vishaya. Always searching for a new experience through any of the sense organs. And thereby the creator as though destroyed the seeker, because he can no longer be a seeker of moksha because he is seeking outwards. Seeking outward, how will one know the inner self which is not different from the Purna Swarupa, Brahma? Thereby, one is always indulging in the Vishayas as soon as one is born in any Sharira. Thereby, the Buddhi is always Chanchala because Vishaycha is always there. Why it is there? Because Anadi Kalena there is Samskara of Vishaya Bhoga. So, that Samskara will give rise to Raga, here called as Icha, then Vishaycha. One who has visheshu ichha yasya sa vishe ichha tasya visheshyasya pumsaha purushasya or pumsa pum puman shashti ekvachana. So this is a bahuri. One who has visheshicha, that kind of a person will necessarily have his buddhi tuned outwards. It will keep on jumping. Antakkarana buddhi chanchala bhavati chanchalayam buddhau Atma Swarupananda Pratibimbo na Bhasate. Then the Atmananda Swarupananda, which can be experienced only through manifestation, only through reflection. Because it is the Swarupa of the subject in the subject-object interaction. When the Atma becomes Jivatma, the Sakshi as the Jiva, Jivatma, Sakshi becomes Jiva with Antakkarana Sambandha, then there is a possibility of the subject-object interaction. And when that kind of a situation arises, which is for everyone, then there is a Pratibimba of Ananda, which becomes an object, reflected Ananda of one's own Swarupa. Reflected as in quotes. I mean, it is not reflection as in a real reflection. Reflection like a light reflects. But then, for a lack of better word, it is called as reflection because it is not you, yourself. Like seeing your eye only through a mirror, otherwise it is not possible to see your eye. Similarly, one can experience one's own manifest attributes through reflection in the antakkarana, through vrittis. Therefore, chanchalayam buddhau, when the satyam, chanchalayam buddhau chanchalayam satyam, atma swarupananda pratibimbaha na bhasate, then the atma pratibimba is not known with particularly ananda as focus. So, here there is a tippana, long one, which is Atma Swabhavata Eva Ananda Swarupa. Atma is, by nature itself, it is Ananda Rupa. Then Manaso Vyakulatayam Sannihitaha Api Padartha Yathana Chakshur Gocharo Bhavati Tatha Yavad Rajo Guna Samparkar Buddhi Chanchala Bhavati Tavad Atmana Ananda Amshuna Buddho Pratibhasate. So giving an example, he explains as to if the mind is not backing the indriyas, in the example chakshu, let's say. So suppose you are looking at something. The eyes are not eyes are completely focused. You have a good eyesight. You are focused on the Vishaya. You are trying to look at something, but you are not trying using your mind. The mind is elsewhere. Somebody is sitting in front of you, showing you something, but then your mind goes elsewhere. Anyatra mano abhuvam, says Shruti. My mind went elsewhere. And when my mind goes elsewhere, then even if the Vishaya is in front of me and the eyes bring in the most of the noise outside, noise or whatever you want to consider it. That is why when you want to focus, you close your eyes, because eyes make up almost 50% of the 50 or more percent of the input from the sense organs. That's why you have to keep on blinking, you know. Otherwise, you know, continuously focus outside. Your ears don't blink, the eyes blink. Because so much of information fed through the eyes come continuously being bombarded by information. No, when there is silence, you don't hear anything. The ears don't need to be closed. They are always open, but still Vishaya is not continuously heard because there can be silence. Unless there is some Shabda, there is always silence. But when the eyes are open, everything is there in front. Something or the other is always there. Even when you close your eyelids, really you are looking at the backside of the eyelids. So eyes are always looking at something, they tire the person out. But even in such a case, when the mind is not backing any of the sense organs, in this example, the eyes, then manaso vyakulatayam sannihita api padartha yathana chakshur gocharo bhavati. It is not really accessible to the eyes. Even if it is accessible, it is not accessible because you can't see. Mind is not backing. When the mind does not back, the rupakara vritti does not take place. Even if it does take place, there is no phala vyapti there, that I know this vishaya, that does not take place. Therefore, meaning what? Antakkarana has to go out through the chakshu to make a vritti really. And then there is phala vyapti, and then I say that ghatamaham janami, etc. But chakshu, although if chakshu is open, still manaso vyakulatayam, mind is jumping here and there, it is elsewhere, then sannitopi, even if it is in close proximity, chakshu cannot see the vishaya. Tatha yavad rajoguna samparkat buddhi chanchala bhavati. Similarly, when buddhi is chanchala due to rajoguna manifesting, then tavad atmanaha anandaushana buddho pratibhasate. When rajoguna is manifest, that time what happens is that the buddhi keeps on jumping. It becomes very active. When it is very active, it is jumping here and there. It is not focused. What is the real focus needed? Focus is for nishtha, to remain in one's own swarupa. Thereby, anandaushaha, atmana anandaushaha na buddho pratibhasate. One does not know one's own swarupa as sukarupa, which is there in shushupti. Yatha darpane prachalati sati, tasmin upalabhyamanopi mukhadi pratibimbo naiva sputaha. Tatha rajoguna samparkat chalantyam, chalantyam buddho atmana sachid aushayoho pratibimbe bhasamani api. Na anandaamsho pratibimbo bhasate. Another example given is darpane prachalati sati. So antakkarana is like a darpana where there is pratibimba. So in the mirror, the way there is a reflection in antakkarana, there is a reflection of the atma. And then the attributes manifest. Not attributes really, swarupa, but then they manifest as attributes. Because they are objectifiable now. But in the example, if the darpana is moving, if the mirror is moving, prachaliti sati, tasmin upalabhyamanopi mukhadi pratibimbo naiva sputa bhavati. It is not clear whether I am seeing myself or I am seeing somebody standing next to me, I do not know, because the mirror is moving. Similarly, when the antakarana moves due to rajoguna samparka, then chalantyam buddhau, when the buddhi chalati, chalati buddhi, then what will happen? Atmana sachid ansha. There is a sachid ansha of the atma. Even if the sachid ansha of atma is manifest, sat and chit, I know that I exist, I know that I am conscious. However, the issue is that the ananda swarupa is not manifest. Sachid aunshayoho pratibimbe bhasamani api na ananda aunsha pratibimbo bhasate. Ishtavastu labhesati. But when one gets the ishtavastu, the vishaya, raga is fulfilled, then what happens? Tad vishayaka iccha. Ishtavastu labhesati. Tad vishayake ichhayaha rajoguna hetuka buddhi chanchalyasya. That which was hetu for the buddhi to be chanchala, that goes away. So vishayake ichhayaha rajoguna hetuka buddhi chanchalyasya cha nivruttau satyam. That vishaya is attained. Therefore, there is no vishaya ichha at that moment. And then when the buddhi becomes achanchala, it loses its chanchalyatvam because of the vishaya being attained, which is what it was craving for. Then what will happen? Prapteshta vastu vishayaka jnana rupaya sattvika vrittya vishayopahita chaitanya swarupanando vibhavyate. Then the rajoguna reduces and sattva manifests, and then sattvika vritti taking place because the vastu is praptana. Ishta vastu is prapta, then what will happen? The cognition of that, knowing that I already have this vastu, then what will happen? The sattvika vritti of that I have this vastu, which is actually one becomes one with the vastu really, because the underlying consciousness is one, that is bhoga. In ghatamaham janami, the consciousness, the chaitanya, which is ghatavachinna, and the antakkarana avachinna me, the vritti. In the vritti, there is pratibimba, my pratibimba, phalavyapti takes place, and that takes away the ajnana, and the jnana, chidrupa jnana, is one between the vishaya, antakkarana and me. There is no second or third chaitanya. It is one. That lighting of the vritti, I know the vritti, through the vritti I know the ghata ityadi vishaya, and there is one, there is no second. Thereby, sattvika vrittya vishayopahita chaitanya, the chaitanya which is vishayena upahita, vishayopahita chaitanya swarupananda, that is really your own swarupananda, that manifests vibhavyate. Athava, another way to explain it is ishtavastu labhamatrena tadvishayaka iccha rupa vrittin vrittihi nivartate. So ishtavastu labhamatrena, just by attaining the vishaya where you have raga, then tadvishayaka iccha rupa vrittir nivartate, then the vishaya iccha vritti itself goes away, which is what is dukkha rupa. Once that goes away, what will happen? Teneiva hetuna anya kachid antarmukha sattviki vritti rudeti. Then sattviki vritti comes in because there is nothing else which is creating any vritti. Of course, I mean, there are multiple things going on and they are all lined up. After one, another comes up. But then we are talking about that moment with one example, that if one has some iccha towards some vishaya, when one attains that vishaya, at least that much is less. When that goes away, then the ananda of the atma, which is the only reality which is there with the antakarana. Beyond the antakarana, there is nothing, because the vishaya which was considered outward has become one in the vritti within. So I know that I have attained it. I am not separate from it anymore. although in not so much of detail, still I have attained and raga is dissolved. Therefore, tene vahetuna anya kachin antarmukha sattviki vritti rudeti. A sattvika vritti comes up and then taya antakrana upahita atmanandaha prakashate. Due to that, what happens is that atmananda manifests in the antakrana. ईदृश अंतर्मुखांतकरण वृत्ति प्रतिफलित आत्मस्वरूपानंद प्रतिबिंबो विषयानंद व्हाट इज कॉल्ड एज विषयानंद इज आत्मस्वरूपानंद प्रतिबिंब इट इज ऑलवेज वन्स ओन स्वरूप विच इज आनंद रूप दैट रिफ्लेक्टिंग इन द अंतकरण इज कॉल्ड एज विषयानंद हाउ डज इट रिफ्लेक्ट नाउ व्हेन ईदृश अंतर्मुख अंतकरण वृत्ति ईदृश मीन्स दिस विषय बीइंग अटेन्ड टेक्स अवे दि आउटवर्ड प्रवृत्ति ऑफ दि अंतकरण एंड इट टर्न्स इनवर्ड रिमेन्स वेर इट इज रियली एंड देन दैट इज ईदृश अंतर्मुख अंतकरण दैट अंतकरण विल हैव वृत्ति व्हाट काइंड ऑफ वृत्ति इट विल हैव द सेम वृत्ति वेर इट इज ट्यून टुवर्ड्स When it was tuned towards ghatapatadi, it had ghatapatadi vritti. When it is antarmukha, it will have antarmukha vritti. Antarmukha, what is there? It is atma, one's own swarupa. Thereby, atma, atmakara vritti. So, pratiphalita, it manifests. Due to that antakkarana vritti, which is antarmukha antakkarana, that vritti will have some pratiphalana. It will manifest something and that pratiphalana is atmas. Swarupananda, Pratibimba, that alone manifests and then that is misunderstood as Vishayananda. That is Vishayananda. It is one's own Swarupa. There is nothing here in this compound at all showing Vishaya. Idrusha is what? Antakarana Upahita Atmananda Prakashate. That is Idrusha. How? Due to Sattvika Vritti. What is that Sattvika Vritti? Antarmukha. Because what? Teneva Hetuna. What is that Hetu? That Hetu is इष्टवस्तु लाभ मात्रेण नॉट दैट लाभ मात्रेण तद्विषयक इच्छा रूप वृत्ति निवर्तनम गोइंग अवे ऑफ द इच्छा वृत्ति विषयक इच्छा वृत्ति गोइंग अवे इट्सेल्फ इज ईदृश अंतर्मुख अंतर्मुखत्वम दैट लीड्स टू अ वृत्ति विच इज वन्स ओन स्वरूप It can be any Vishaya. The more the craving towards the Vishaya, the more the Dukkha and more the attainment will bring Sukha. If we crave something more, then there is more intense Dukkha. Then when you attain it, you feel that you have got more Sukha because that more Dukkha goes away. Once more Dukkha goes away, obviously there will be feeling of more Sukha, but it is just the same Atmananda which is manifest now. You are further away due to more craving. That is the idea here. Idrisha antarmukhantakkarana vritti pratiphalita atmaswarupananda pratibimbo vishyanandaha pratibimbanandaha leshananda iti cha kathyate. And that itself is called as pratibimbanandaha leshananda iti cha kathyate. This is the tippana. Going back to the moola. सो चंचल चंचलायां बुद्धो आत्मस्वरूपानंद प्रतिबिंबो न भासते दिस आत्मस्वरूपानंद विच इज पॉसिबल ओनली व्हेन दी बुद्धि इज स्थिर व्हेन विल बुद्धि बी स्थिर व्हेन देयर इज नो विषय इच्छा अभिलषित विषय लाभे तो क्षण मात्र बुद्धि स्थिरी भवति दी बुद्धि बिकम्स अचंचला इट बिकम्स स्थिर स्थिरी भवति व्हेन स्थिरी भवति व्हेन व्हेन अभिलषित विषय लाभे व्हेन वन डिजायर्स सम विषय दैट इज अटेन्ड देन व्हाट हैपेंस क्षण मात्रम ओनली अ मोमेंट फॉर अ ओनली अ मोमेंट द बुद्धि बिकम्स स्टिल तदा बुद्धि वृत्तिर अंतर्मुखा भवति देन द बुद्धि अंतकरण नॉट हैविंग एनी अदर वृत्ति द सात्विक वृत्ति ऑफ वन्स ओन स्वरूप मैनिफेस्ट तस्याम अंतर्मुखायाम वृत्तौ आत्मस्वरूपानंद प्रतिफलति देन आत्मस्वरूपानंद मैनिफेस्ट इन दैट बुद्धि तादृश आत्मस्वरूपानंद प्रतिबिंब अनुभवितु पुंसः वन हु हैज दिस अनुभव ऑफ प्रतिबिंब आत्मानंद प्रतिबिंब अनुभव फॉर हिम फॉर सच अ पर्सन विषयेभ्यो ममानंदो जायत इति भ्रांतिरुत्पद्यते. ही मिसअंडरस्टैंड्स ड्यू टू दैट सिंक्रोनाइजेशन ऑफ टाइमिंग वाई अटेन द विषय एंड देर इज मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ सुख काकतालीय न्याय. If a bird comes and sits on a coconut tree and the coconut falls at that time, a crow comes and sits in, is really the crow the cause for the coconut falling? The tiny bird there is not the real cause for the coconut falling. So kakataliya nyaya, it has just happened so. Really, it is not due to that crow. In this case, what has happened? There is, I mean, not completely that way, because it is only to drive home the point that it is not that kaka which is the cause. Similarly, here it is not the vishaya which is the cause. What happens? The vishaya was the cause for dukkha, not for sukha. That dukkha going away because the craving goes away. Vishayebhyo mama anando jayata iti bhrantir utpadyate. That is nothing but bhranti. And Tippanakara says on that bhranti as दुखात्मक विषयानुभव कालीन सुखस्य वस्तुतः आत्मस्वरूप सुखत्वे अपि विषय निष्ठतया तज्जन्यत्वेन च तत्सुखस्य भानं भ्रमाद् भवति. ऑल्दो इट इज ट्रू दैट दुखात्मक विषय इटसेल्फ दुखात्मक रियली दुखात्मक विषय अनुभव कालीन सुखस्य व्हेन यू द विषय इज नॉट सुख रूप इट इज रियली दुख रूप बिकॉज यू वॉन्ट इट एंड इट टेक्स यू अवे. Any vishaya, even if you want it or you don't want it, it takes you away from your swarupa. Going away from swarupa is dukkha. Then dukkhatmaka vishaya, how does it give rise to sukha? Dukkhatmaka vishaya anubhava kalina. When you have anubhava of that vishaya, then that time there is sukha. Anubhava kalina sukhasya. The kala synchronization is there. Vastuta atma swarupa sukhatvyapi. Although that is atma swarupa sukha itself, still vishaya nishthataya तज्जन्यत्वेन च तत्सुखस्य भानं भ्रमाद् भवति. बट द थिंकिंग दैट द आनंद इज विषयनिष्ठ इट इज देयर इन द विषय एंड दिस विषय हैज कॉज्ड सुख इन मी तज्जन्यत्वेन च तत्सुखस्य भानं दैट एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ सुख बीइंग एट्रिब्यूटेड टू द विषय इज भ्रम देयरफॉर भ्रमाद् भवति भानं सुख भानं विषय सुख भानं भ्रमाद् भवति. यथा शुनः शुष्क अस्थि खादन काले स्वतालु जन्य रक्ते अस्थि जन्यत्वं भ्रमः तद्वत. एग्जांपल गिवन इज लाइक अ डॉग शुनः डॉग बाइटिंग ऑन अ ड्राई बोन. यू सी यू नो इन इवन इन कॉमिक्स यू सी अ डॉग रनिंग यू नो टॉम एंड जेरी एंड थिंग्स लाइक dog is running after a bone. The bone is dry, it keeps on chewing on it. And when it chews, the sharp edges, when the bone gets cut, the bone starts hurting really. It hurts within. And the blood that oozes out of that inner, the inner parts of the mouth of the dog, the taste of the blood is what is felt as coming from the bone. The bone does not have that blood, but the dog likes the taste of the blood. It is its own blood that it is tasting, but it thinks that, oh, this, look at this bone. So yatha shunaha shushka asti khadana kale, when it is eating, that time itself there is a synchronization of timing. It bites on the bone and then there is taste of blood. Swatalu janya rakte, in the palate there is, palate is bleeding, the palate is soft, the teeth may be very sharp, but then the bone is also sharp and that is hurting the palate which is soft. Then there is rakta. Then swatalu janya rakte asti janyatva bhramaha, that the taste which has come up, the rasaswada that it is getting is due to the bone is a misunderstanding, it is Brahma. So it is, the dog knows no better. Unfortunately, we don't know any better when we hanker after Vishayas for Sukha. Tadvata, our case is no better. That is why in Adhyasa Bhashya, Bhagwan Bhashyakara says, even for Jnani it is the same. Because I think there he says, the Pashutulyatvam, for that he uses a word, Pashvabhis Samanaha. So when one is interacting with the world, one is the pravritti nivritti, all is like Pashu. Even for a jnani, really, when he is interacting, because there is a disconnect from, we'll see in this part itself, it will come up. There is some disconnect. He knows, he is not confused like the dog or like us, ajnanis. The jnani is not confused. But still, the vyavahara is like the Pashu looking for sukha, avoiding dukkha. It is the same story all the way for all jivas. It is no different for a manushya. So long tika, less moola there. What does the moola say further? So tadrsha atmaswarupananda pratibimbam anubhavituh pumsaha visebhyo mamanando jayata iti bhrantir utpadyate. That is a bhranti. Vastutastu naivasti jade visaya anandaleshu api. In reality, there is not even a bit of ananda in the vishaya. Kin, because it is jada, jada vastu does not have ananda. Kincha anandot anandotpatter यत्किंचित विषय जन्य जन्य आनंद अनुभवतः पुंसः विषयांतरे इच्छात्पत्ति दशायामपि प्राचीन विषयानंदो अनुवर्तितुम अर्हति. Why so विषय does not have आनंद? Because किंच मोरोवर आनंदो आनंदोत्पत्तेर विषयाधीनत्वे सति. If the आनंदोत्पत्ति was due to विषय, had dependency on vishaya. Adhinatvam is dependency. If anandotpatti had dependency on the vishaya, then yatkinchid vishaya janya anandam anubhavatah pumsa. For a person who is having anubhava of ananda, which is vishaya janya ananda, there is a supposition. If it were so, let's assume that the Vishaya gave rise to Ananda. Vishaya had Ananda, it gave rise to. Only that which has can give me. So Vishaya has Ananda and it gives me Ananda, so that it lends me Ananda and I become happy. If that were to be true, supposing that yatkinchit, even if there is a little, whatever amount you think, all that Ananda that comes up, that Ananda is due to Vishaya, then there is some Ananda. Whatever that Ananda is there in the Vishaya and Vishaya Janya Ananda in me, that I am having anubhava of, for that kind of me, for that kind of person, anubhavatah pumsa vishayantare ichchotpatti dashayamapi. If he has attained the vishaya one, then vishayantara vishaya two, if he goes towards, he wants this second vishaya now, then vishaya one is prapta. At least he should have that vishaya one sukha. Ichchotpatti dashayamapi prachina vishayananda vishaya one ananda. Anuvarti tumar harti, it should have an anuvarti, it should continue. But it is not there. That is why samsaranam. I have one vishaya, I am happy with it in that moment, but then I crave for another, the earlier sukha is gone, there is dukkha again. No, no, I want this also. Then you get that this also I want, I get that, and then there is a little sukha, then a third thing comes up in the mind, and the chain continues endlessly. Life of becoming something that you want to be and something that you think you are not, and on the other hand, want to give up something that you think you are and want to become some kind of a person who does not have these flaws. That is samsaranam. Natu tatha asti anubhava, but such anubhava is not there. We have one Vishaya Ananda, then as soon as we crave for another Vishaya, the earlier Ananda goes away. That Ananda does not stay. That's why Anitya. Nitya Anitya Vastu Viveka is this very thing. Asmat Siddhante Tu. However, In our Siddhanta, unlike the Purvapakshi who thinks that there is Vishayananda, Purvapakshi is every one of us, Charvakas. Asmat Siddhante tu Vishayantarasaktya Punarapi Buddhi Chanchalye Sati Tasyam Chanchala Buddhau Na Swarupananda Pratibimbo Bhati Iti Samadhanam Niyam. But in Siddhanta, what happens is that Vishayantara Asaktya, when there is a Vishaya to Asakti, Raga towards another Vishaya, then Punarapi Buddhi Chanchalye, then Buddhi becomes Astira, Astiri Bhavati. When the Buddhi becomes Chanchala, then what happens? Tasyam Chanchala Buddhya, Buddhau, in that Buddhi which is Chanchala now. So this Tasyam is Buddhi Chanchalye Sati, that is Sati Saptami, and Tasyam Chanchala Buddha is Adhikarana. Tasyam Chanchala Buddhau Adhikarane, in that Adhikarana, na Swarupananda Pratibimbo Bhati. Swarupananda Pratibimbo na Bhasati, na Bhati. Then it goes away. Because earlier what had happened? The Vishaya one attained, the Buddhi had become Stiri. So Stira Buddhi made this Sattvika Vritti, which is Antarmukha Vritti, which gave Sukha. Now that Antarmukhattvam is gone because Buddhi becomes Chanchala again, because we want something else now. It is Samadhanam Niyam. That is the arrangement. We should understand that arrangement. Kincha Anyat. Further, Yadi Vishayat Eva Anando Niyamena Jayeta. If it were true, further, that Vishayat Eva Anandaha Jayate. Jayeta. Jayate would be, you know, Latlakara, but Jayeta is Vidhiling. Had it been so that the Vishayananda were to be born, Shakyarthe, had it been so, Niyamena. As a rule, it is, if you say no, Vishaya Sambandadeva Sukaha Jayate. If you make such a rule, then what will happen? Tada Pravasad Agada Putra Darshana Janyanandaha Sada Anuvartitum Arhati. Then what will happen is that the Vishaya proximity being there, when Pravasad Agada Putra Darshana Janyanandaha Ananda, when the father and son are separated. Let's say son has gone out and he has come back from pravasa, some travel. Then pravasad agata putra. The person, the child who has come back from travel, you know, gone to a hostel or something for many years, comes back, whatever. Pravasad agata putra darshana janya ananda. The pita has ananda, mata has ananda. Oh, my son is home, you know. The smile does not go away for a good many days. And people look at the parents and say, oh, I know you, I can see on your face, I can see that your son is back home. So, pravasad agata putra darshana janyananda sada anivartitum arhati. But it is not so. Only for a while. Natu tatha bhavati. It is not, that smile is not going to stay forever. Finally, the distance which has taken the sun away, that has been bridged by the sun coming home. It took away the dukkha of the separation, and Swarupananda is manifest because it has become Sattviki now. The Antakkarana is Antarmukha really. Although one sees the Putra, the desire for the Putra's, the darshan of the Putra is gone because Putra is right there. Therefore, one is experiencing one's own Swarupa. Then what will happen? The Putra is there, but does the Ananda stay? No. After a while, there is Dukkha again because there is craving for Vishaya. Or, you know, you look at somebody else's Putra and say, oh, why can't my son be like that? He's back home. That is the Dukkha due to separation is gone, but Dukkha due to I want my son to be like this has come up. However the father or the mother is, but the son should be like this, that Dukkha is an add-on now. Tatha hi kasyachit priyatarah putraha chiraprabhasi kalantare pratyagamat tad darshanakshane jayamanah pituranandaha chirakalam avichinnataya anuvartitum arhati. It is explained, Sangrahavakya has been explained, as one who has putra, has, you know, has traveled long has come back home. Kalantare Pratyagamut has come after a long time. Then, in the moment of seeing him, there is Pituho has an Pita has Ananda. Pitur Anandaha Jayate. Jayamana Anandaha, that Ananda which is born, Chirakalam Avichinnataya Anuvartitum Arhati. It should stay for a long, long time. In fact, it should stay forever if the Putra is going to be there forever. Ananda Hetu of Putrasya Sada Sannihi Tattva. Because Putra is in close proximity all the while, then the Ananda should be there continuously. Natu Tatha Anubhuyate. But it is not so. It is not experienced. Siddhante tu Putra Darshanadi Putra Darshanad sorry. Siddhante tu Putra is an example. Putra Darshan is an example. So Siddhante tu, in our case, however, Siddhante tu Putra Darshanadi Tattad Vishayajanya Anandasya Chiram Anuvarti Anuvrittihi Chiram Ananuvrittihi. There should be Anuvritti, but it is not so. There is Ananuvritti. Ananda does not continue. How do you explain that in the Siddhanta? In Siddhanta, take Putra Darshana or anything else. Adi. Putra Darshana Adi Tattad Vishaya Janya. Putra is a Vishaya. So Putra Janya. Putra Darshana Janya Sukha Ananda or Adi Padena. Adi is another Vishaya. Any of this. So Putra Darshana Adi is Tattat. Each of these in the Putra Darshanadi compound, whatever you add, Tattad Vishaya, those particular Vishayas will give rise to Ananda. That is the thinking. So Putra Darshanadi Tattad Vishaya Janya Anandasya Chiram Ananurtihi. There is no continuity of those specific Anandas, Vishayanandas, Putra Darshanananda, then Dhanalabha Ananda, whatever Ananda, none of these continue. In Siddhanta also, of course, in Siddhanta also it will not continue. But how do you explain in your case? We say, evam upapadyate. In this manner we explain, tattad vishaya labakshane buddhir nischali bhavati. Same thing we have explained, repeated again. Buddhi becomes nischali, nischali bhavati, tada nischalyam buddhau. Tada nischalyam buddhi vrittau atma swarupananda pratibimbito bhavati. Then the atma ananda becomes, it reflects in that chira buddhi. It is achanchala buddhi. Unlike that moving mirror, the buddhi is not like a moving mirror anymore. It is still. Therefore, pratibimba is anubhuta now. You have the experience of pratibimba ananda. Saeva anando anubhuyate. That ananda is one's own ananda, not vishyananda. Tataha vishyantarechaya punarapi buddhesh chanchalye sati tasyam buddhau swarupananda pratiphalanasya vichedat purata eva satyapi prachina vishayena anandanuvrittihi. Therefore, even if the vishaya is right there with you, putra has come back home and is staying back, still there is dukkha because vishyantarechaya, when it comes up, then buddhi becomes chanchala. And chanchala buddhi will lose the swarupananda pratibimba. Therefore, swarupananda pratiphalanasya vichedat, there is purata eva sati api prachina vishaya. Even if the earlier vishaya is right in front of you, ananda anurti na bhavati. Tasmad na vishaya vishaye asti ananda. Tasmad vishaya ananda nasti. There is no ananda in vishaya. Kincha. Moreover, yadi niyamena vishayadhina eva anando bhavet tada samadav yoganando na prakasheta. Then there won't be any ananda in samadhi, which is called as yogananda. Yoga chitta vritti nirodha. There is chitta vritti nirodha. Where from will you get the vishaya vritti? Anyway, we'll see this in the next part. I'll stop here. Sukam nityam swaprakasham vyapakam nama rupayo adhishtanam buddhya bodhyam buddher kyatna nirmala aparam sarva vedanta vedyam pratyak param maha tadevahan namatyonyat iti menishchitamatihi. Namaste. Again, if there are questions, hold on to those or ask on the group. I have to go. I have another patha to attain. So, namaste.
Hari Om.
Hari Om.